a la Shmoop. Sometimes the greatest power comes in the smallest packages. Take David, for example. Goliath never knew what hit him. How about Napoleon? He certainly didn't win any battles because of his height. There's a reason we have something in math called a power. It's small and unassuming, but it packs quite a punch. Also referred to as an exponent, a power is a way of abbreviating very large numbers in order to make them manageable. See that itty-bitty number up to the right of the other number? That guy's the exponent. An exponent can take an expression like 5 times 5 times 5 times 5 and express it this way. We're multiplying 4 5s together, so our exponent is a 4. Or as we might say, we are taking 5 to the 4th power. Sometimes you'll have a bunch more numbers to multiply together than just 4 of them. But life's too precious to waste it multiplying zillions of numbers the long way, hence the shortcut. What about when the power is 1? Because our exponent is telling us that there's only 1 7, he doesn't get multiplied by anything else. So it's the same as a plain old 7. When a power is 0, however, the number is always equal to 1, which really is the loneliest number. We've been there. Moving on, an exponent can also be negative. In that case, you'll need to take the reciprocal of the number and then change the exponent to a positive number. So, for example, if you got a 2 to the negative 3rd power, it's the same as the reciprocal of 2, 1 half to the 3rd power. Half times half times half is 1 eighth. So, as you can see, they may not look like much, but powers are quite powerful. They can abbreviate many big numbers, and they can reduce others to rubble. So have fun on your power trip. Don't forget to send us a postcard.